your story. What is the reason, you ask? The story needs to be told, and if there is no one left to tell it, its meaning will be lost. Why now, you ask, when all lies shattered around us? Yes, you are right. But we are at the end of times, and when something ends, something else begins. So my story might yet live on in this world. They gave me different names. They called me the hero, the one who sacrificed everything to save the people and the land. They called me the destroyer, who betrayed the trust of all races and brought the end of times. I am both, and I am neither. I want you to hear me, see through my eyes, understand the reasons for the things I have done. And before I pass from this world, I need to be judged. I need you to judge me. Our land is dying, and we are dying with it. This was not always the case. Artara was once a place of wonder and beauty. The five races thrived in peace and harmony. Then, long ago, something happened. A cataclysm of unimaginable proportions. Something so disastrous, we don't even have a name for it. For when it destroyed our civilization, it took with it all knowledge of history. The past is now lost to us. Our future is uncertain. We are left trapped in a bleak and dismal present. The land itself is our enemy now. The weather extreme and unpredictable. Droughts persist for several weeks, followed by floods that wash everything away. Yet our gravest problem is the lack of sunlight. Storm clouds shroud our world in everlasting twilight. Without the sun, we are unable to grow food, and so we struggle to survive this dark world, a seemingly hopeless battle. I look back now to when I was a young boy, living on the fringe of the human domain. While hunting for food, I stumbled upon ruins uncovered by a recent earthquake. A bad omen, normally avoided. But this time, something drew me in. Descending the stairs led me to a crystal throne which glittered with swirling light. I felt strangely compelled to approach and sit. As I took my place upon it, a sudden torrent of light enveloped me. The illumination overwhelmed my senses. I grew nauseous and weak, but before I lost consciousness, the throne ejected me to the floor. I fled and told no one what happened, for fear of being deemed tainted and banished from the village, for this was the way of my people. I tried to forget the experience, to convince myself it was my overactive imagination. But the visions that followed said otherwise. Every night, the nightmares came. Their torment highlighted my confusion, as each morning I remembered little, fragmented images, words which made no sense, nothing more. I would have thought myself mad if not for the strange, incomprehensible symbols I often drew in the sand. Proof that forces beyond my understanding were at work. People in my vicinity kept their distance, and I think they feared me. Over time, they learned to tolerate my unusual nature. But I was always alone, left to brood and ponder my strange fate. One winter, it all came flooding back to me. I realized the crystal throne sat not at the bottom of some ancient ruins, but at the top of a construction incomprehensible in scale. That the ruins were not ruins of some lost city or ancient castle, but a single massive tower buried deep within the earth, and buried upside down. Some unexplainable force had lifted the construction into the sky, rotated it, and driven it into the ground. In that moment of clarity, I knew one thing above all others. I had to go back to that place, for the power within was the one thing that could save Artara. Years later, I found myself a commander in the last human kingdom's militia. The king, a just man and good friend, granted me a favor for my years of loyal service. I had but one request, a small force of men and resources to return to the village of my birth and explore the tower. Preoccupied by an eroding empire, the king held little interest in ancient ruins and towers. He did, however, see the reclaiming of a long-abandoned village on the border of an ever-shrinking kingdom as a boost to the people's morale. He gave me what I requested, and his blessing. So, here I am, returning to the very place which has haunted me my entire life. It is a desolate place now. Time has not been kind to my village. Most of it has rotted or been washed away. Yet the tower remains just as I remember it. I am in awe of the power within, and perhaps fearful. The men and I are setting up the camp in the village, while Kane and Maiv, two of my most capable warriors, will scout the tower. Once again, I feel its call. We must uncover its secrets. We must find a way to reach the power within. If we fail, it will be the end of us.